Let's take a look at creating a new test based on some industry standards. We'll start by selecting Configure Color Check. Next, we'll select New. Name this appropriately, for example, in the area to select Color Check Environment. If we want to base this test on G7, then we would select that environment, G7 Process Control Master. Now the characterization dataset reveals proper test charts specific to G7. If we select Standard Simulation, the characterization dataset displays the proper test charts accordingly. You'll see ISO, Fogra, CGATS. These are the options we have. So let's go back and make this test for G7. We'll give the swatch name appropriate name. Default quick set will be applied in the case of some standard simulations. So I will select my G7 quick set, which will impact my color management as the recommended G7 input profiles. In the G7 quick set, we'll notice the recommended G7 profiles. This will be the color management applied to my G7 test swatch. Notice the message at the bottom of the characterization data set. The input profiles in your quick set are consistent with the selection. I have the checkbox enabled only display data sets compatible with swatch quick sets. If the G7 quick set was not selected, there would be less choices in the display. This will only display the appropriate G7 quick set is selected. We can see the full complement of test types. Therefore, depending on the color management selection, the list will be filtered. In the Options button, we can see controls we have to set. These settings will be saved to our test. We can set the expiration time if you want to set this for 1 day or a week or possibly a month. Or you can just turn this on for a report-only type test. You run the test, measure the swatch charts, see how close you are to your tolerances, but it will not update the status in the rip queue. I'm going to enable my verification expiration for 1 month. Now I'll select OK. Now we see the tests in our list. We notice our names of our tests, the environment, the selection type, and the expiration date or the report type. To run this test, we'll simply select G7 swatch and click the print button. We'll notice our printer media mode settings as well as our quick set, and we'll select print. I'll close my configure color check. I'll print my chart. Once my chart has been completed, I'll measure by double-clicking the file and enter the job properties attributes specific to the color check. And at this point, I'll begin my measurements. When the measurements are complete, we can see the results of our test chart. At this point, I can select the report button, save my file, and then I can view this and see my metrics and my verification status and my tolerances. I can see all the patches and the information below. And that is how you create a new test chart.